Hi, this is Sharon Field for Split Coast Stampers, and today I'm showing you Shoji Screen Stamping. Here's a list of the supplies we'll be using, starting with waffle paper. Gold works better than silver. Whisper white cardstock, multi-purpose adhesive sheet, a well-inked basic black stamp pad, and two solid image stamps, one for your background and one for the foreground. We'll begin by placing the waffle paper shiny side down on a protected work surface and ink your background image and stamp. Notice that it bleeds through to your work surface. As you stamp, you'll want to move your piece around so that you don't hit that again. Placing it dull side down, shiny side up, we'll now stamp with your second image around the perimeter, leaving a little space between them. I'm stamping in an arch because I plan to cut an archway for a garden when I'm done with this piece. Once you're done, you can turn that over and stamp between the prior stamped images. This will give you light and shadow on your Shoji screen. Notice I forgot to stamp along the bottom on the front, so that's not a big deal. It's a creative opportunity. When I'm done, I'll just turn it over and stamp along the bottom. My image is still wet, so as I quickly put my supplies away, once I'm done, I will peel back my grid paper, fold it in half, and use a clean surface for the next step. We'll be using the multi-purpose adhesive sheet and our bone folder. Bone fold the exterior of the multi-purpose sheet and it'll help the adhesive release from the protective paper. Once you've peeled that and the little strip along the edge, you can place the adhesive side down on the back, non-shiny side of the waffle paper. Press down lightly with your fingers and then use your bone folder to adhere it well. Turn it over to the other side and bone fold again. That'll give you nice little creases. When you try to peel it back, if it doesn't release, then you just bone fold it again. You'll see the glue pulling up and then you can pull it back and the glue will stay in place. Oh, see, now mine didn't stay in place, so I'm gonna bone fold it one more time, pressing firmly on both sides, front and back. And then now when I peel it back, that adhesive is going to stay with the waffle paper, and that's where we want it. So adhesive side down, we're going to attach that to our Whisper White cardstock, cut slightly smaller than the waffle paper. After trimming, we can put it on our card. These are just a few of our samples that I've made using the Shoji Screen Stamping Technique. Hope you like it. Thanks.